الله الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. The recitation في صلاة الفجر for anybody wondering يعني سورة الملك توز ده قراءة وفي الإمام الكسائي ده رواية وفي الإمام الدوري. الدوري عن الكسائي is one of the narrations. As I mentioned before, 10 famous متواتر قراءات. 10 famous متواتر قراءات means narrated يعني from رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. And each one of them had two famous narrations. Two famous narrations. So the قراءة that we all know is the قراءة of عاصم, الإمام عاصم from الكوفة, and the narration of الإمام حفص. That's the famous one that we know. الإمام عاصم have another narrator, his name is الإمام شعبة. So he has شعبة and حفص. شعبة and حفص. Actually, شعبة comes number one, حفص comes number two. Even though حفص is very famous due to the Ottoman Empire, the Ottoman, you know, the Turkish, they chose the حفص. حفص was the famous one in that time in Turkey, and they spread it because of that. That's how it became famous. Even though حفص was the least famous among all the 20 narrations. Yeah, the least famous among all 20. And it just became famous in the last century or so, two centuries. Yeah, Warsha and Nafi were more famous, and now it's only in Algeria, Morocco, and part of Tunisia and all that. It was the qira'ah of Ahl al-Madina. Qira'ah of Imam Nafi, the qira'ah of Ahl al-Madina. Imam Nafi have two narrators, Qalun and Warsh, and one of the narration was Imam Malik, the faqih. يعني. Imam Malik of Fiqh, he was also have a narration from Imam Nafi. And the famous qira'ah of Ahl Mecca was qira'ah Ibn Kathir, not Ibn Kathir al-Tafsir, but there is Imam Abdullah Ibn Kathir from, يعني, considered like tabi' tabi'in. He was the Imam of al-Haram of Mecca, and he was the qari' among the 10 qura', and they have two narrators, al-Bazzi wa Qumbal, and the third of narrations was Imam al-Shafi'i, the faqih also. But it's not famous because people study from him fiqh, not qira'ah. No. Maybe inshallah one night we'll do that. What do you think? We can do like a preview of this very interesting subject. But to, today, one of the qira'at, Imam al-Kisai, and he is like number 7 in Imam al-Shatibi's order. It doesn't mean that he is 7 in value, يعني. No, but he is number 7. يعني. Imam Nafi', Imam Duri, Imam Abu Amr, and then Imam Ibn Amir, Imam Nafi' Ibn Kathir, Abu Amr Ibn Amir, عاصم, then Hamza and Al-Kisai, those are the 7. Then you have Abu Ja'far, Yaqub, and Khalaf Al-Ashir, those are 10. And each one of them have two narrators. And each one of the narrators have his own ahkam of tajween and all of that. Like you study the rules of tajween. So 20, and that times 20. So this was number one of them. You know. Imam Al-Kisai, and as you notice, you know, he make idgham, hal tara becomes had. Had tari, you know, like tara becomes tari, ahda becomes ahdi, you know, make imala, and it's called the imala of the fatha alif. Ahda, Imam Warsh will say ahda, and Imam al Kisai will say ahdi, like this. Fatha, middle, and imala. So that's one famous of. And also when he stops at the ha at the end, al afidi, shajari, like this. You know, he will do that imala also of the ha. What else? And then some of the changes, يعني. فَسَتَعْلَمُونَ becomes فَسَيَعْلَمُونَ, for example. Alhamdulillah, يعني. So this all was narrations to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Good, Dr. Sa. So, inshallah, this is a little preview. We back to Riyad al-Saliheen. فالإمام النووي رحمه الله. And we are with the section of مراقبة. In case you need refreshment. Section of مراقبة, watchfulness for Allah سبحانه وتعالى. تراقب الله في العمل. When you pray, you are like watching for Allah عز وجل. Remember, we said that you worship Allah as if you see Him. If you are not able, you kind of realize that He's watching you all the time. Then you can improve your quality for Allah. And be careful why I'm saying that, because you are watching for someone. You improve the quality of your ibadah, that's a musibah. You know that, right? So someone like is praying very fast, and when a person enters, you know, they kind of fix the quality. That's muraqaba, but not muraqaba for Allah. You get the concept of muraqaba now. Muraqaba means you're watching for someone watching you. Okay, so if you are doing it for that someone, that's wal'adu billah, can be shirk, you know, be careful. Astaghfirullah, right? So you can be starting good niyyah, but you are doing the quality bad. Okay, so someone starting the salah with good niyyah, it's for Allah Azza wa Jalla, you're doing it for Allah, but the quality is bad. Then when somebody watching for you, the quality becomes good. That's now idkhal shirk now. That the niyyah corrupted right there. Niyyah is corrupted right there because you enter, a person entered what? The watchfulness for someone else. مراقبة هذه تكون لله فقط سبحانه وتعالى. You are watching for Allah in your siyam, in your zakah, in your hajj, in your coming to the masjid, in your sitting right now, in your studying. This is between you and Allah. That's why, ya akhwani, my brothers and sisters, we have sisters here, we have to be very, very careful that it is a continuous effort. This work of the heart is a continuous effort. Wallahi ya akhwani, by Allah. If we just get busy with that, we will not be distracted by too many things around us. We just get busy with that. That you are sitting there being scared that your heart will be taken away from you. Because the heart is like that precious jewel that all the shayateen, like thieves, yani, trying to break in. It's like in a big safe. That safe of the taqwa of Allah, muraqaba, al-ihsan, khashya. You know, all of this is like that safe. Those are the combinations, huh? You know, like the bank, big bank, you have the vault, and in the vault there is that crown jewel or that precious, you know, precious stone that nobody is allowed to even look at it. Okay? And then you have a very strong vault with combination. This combination is khashya, taqwa, ihsan, you know. So if each time one weaker means one digit is cracked in the code, you know. So then the shayateen will get in and will grab that heart, will look at it, will hold it, will, you know, put the germs on it and all of this kind of things. So what you want now, that's your heart right there, subhanallah. So keep the heart always intact, and if you are always focused, where is my heart right now? This is the stage of muraqabah. Muraqabah is like watching, like where is my heart right now, and I'm watching for Allah Azza wa Jalla. Then it would be protected at all times, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. So we studied the long hadith of Rasulullah s.a.w. with Jibreel alayhi salam teaching us our deen. And then we are with second hadith today, inshaAllah, rabbil alameen. Al-hadith al-thani, the second hadith in the Riyad al-Saliheen. And this is, by the way, a hadith mentioned in the 40 hadith. Imam al-Nawawi also made the 40 hadith. You know the 40 hadith al-Nawawi, very famous, mashaAllah. And he collected 40 hadith gathering the deen of al-Islam all around the deen of al-Islam. And taba'an, there is a hadith which has some weakness in its chain, that whoever collect 40 hadith of my saying, hadith of Rasulullah, that Allah Azza wa Jalla will grant him the shafa'ah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So there are many imams competed in collecting 40 hadith because of that. And why, when you say why 30, why 40? So that's why. Imam al-Nawawi was not the only one, was not the last one who made a 40 hadith. Was not the first one, was not the last one. But Allah Azza wa Jalla granted his, ajib, amazing, granted him that fame. Yani, Muslims differ in many things and many madhab and many, and everybody study 40 hadith. They differ everything and everybody have Riyad al-Saliheen. Imam al-Nawawi has that barakah, subhanallah. And he died in his 30s, yani, right? Young. So, yeah, Imam al-Nawawi, he didn't get married, yani, so he was that busy with writing in the sunnah and in fiqh and all of the other things. So he made 40 hadith. And the second hadith in this section, on Abi Dharrin, Sayyidina Abu Dharr, radiallahu anhu, sahabi of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jundab ibn Junaidah, that's his name. Jundab ibn Junaidah. Jundab ibn Junaidah al-Ghifari, from Ghifar. Bani Ghifar is the tribe of Abu Dharr, radiallahu anhu. And this tribe was famous that they cut the road for any traveler, you know. So that's why, you know, when he went to Mecca and accepted Islam, and announced the Islam, they started beating him and all that. Then Al-Abbas, the uncle of Rasulullah, come and say, are you crazy? You know what you're doing now? You beat him means your caravans will not pass. So that's Bani Ghifar. And all of them became Muslim to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, became among the best. See, that's how Islam changes people. Wallahi akhwan, and when you read in the seerah and you read in the stories of the Islam of the Sahaba, we don't become very fast to judge people. Right? Everybody has a chance to be good. But we just give them the chance to be good. We help them to be good. If they are not good, this is their choice. Yeah, what is the worst at the end of the day? You tried your best, you did not judge people, you give them the da'wah, you invite them and they did not come. What did you lose? You gained a lot. You gained lots of reward and you made them know that you are open. You made them know that we people of the masjid are welcoming, right? So we win. We actually won something. If you don't win somebody, you won lots of things in the community. At least your name and your attribute, that you are welcoming to everybody. You are a person who is waiting for others to come, not shunning them away. Not. You see the beauty of the da'wah? That's how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his enemies, if any one of them enters to ask for da'wah, he tells them, no, you are my enemy, I don't like you, just go away. No. When did he do that? Give me one incident, yeah. When did he do that? The worst of the worst will come to him. It's either they become Muslim or they just leave. You see? But at the end, what do we have now to say? He was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam welcoming for everybody. Right? So that's what he left for us. So this is Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, and just the barakah of Abu Dharr brought us this. Subhanallah. Jundab ibn Junaydah. Also, this same hadith that we are going to mention is narrated by another Sahabi. Imam Nawawi bringing narration from two Sahabi. So he's saying, عن أبي ذر جندب بن جنادة رضي الله عنه وأبي عبد الرحمن معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنهما. يعني both. سيدنا أبو ذر سيدنا معاذ both narrated this hadith. معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنهما. عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said اتق الله حيثما كنت. اتق الله حيثما كنت. Fear Allah wherever you are. وأتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحها and follow the bad deed with the good deed, it will wipe it out. It will erase it. The good deed will erase the bad deed. وخالق الناس بخلق حسن and deal with people with good mannerism, with good conduct, good behavior. خلق حسن. Remember that word. I want you to say it. خلق حسن. خلق حسن. Say it. خلق حسن. What do we need, يا إخواني, now in our community? خلق حسن. ما شاء الله. Memorize that. So whenever anybody tell you, what does this community need, يا شيخ, to thrive? Say the word. خلق حسن. الله أكبر. Let's work according to it, inshallah. It's very simple, but very hard to do. Because you know, خلق حسن, we all have it. Trust me, in the fitrah, Allah created everybody with khuluq hasan. But as I told you, it is like a precious thing. Hawa, desire, the politics, the family, the culture, the age, this, that, my right, your duty, takes away from it. So it's up to you. You want the khuluq al-hasan to come or not? خلق الحسن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم الله عز وجل told him وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم. طيب, I want to ask you a question. Do you think رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم never يعني got angry inside? He did. Do you think صلى الله عليه وسلم was not hurt, يعني hurt his feelings were hurt before many times? But that's not the issue. The issue is what you do, how you act upon it, and how you act upon it. His feeling is hurt. He's angry, but Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "You suppress the anger. You forgive the people. You do that." That means anger exists. That means the feeling was hurt. Many times they hurt the feeling of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he replied, "If I am not just, who's going to be just? You know why you will say this? You know, and he give people more when they hurt him sallallahu alaihi wasallam." That means, you know, the act, the khuluq al-hasan is what matters. is what matters. Nobody tells you to get rid of your feelings. Your feelings will be there because you're a human being. If somebody does something irritating, you'll be irritated. If somebody angers you, you will be angry. If somebody, like, you know, put you down or something like that, you'll be hurt. That's common. That's okay. It's expected. We are all human beings. But what you do next, that's what counts on you. Mafhoom ya akhwana, understood? This is what counts. Well, that's why the hadith narrated by Imam al-Tirmidhi, this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I call this hadith, subhanallah, the package, the whole package. I gave one khutbah about it, I said this is the whole package. And this can be a curriculum for the youth, and for adults as well, but a curriculum for youth. Three stages, 101, 102, 103. Like, you know, the college classes, you have like number one, number two, number three, and this one is the same. One is aqeedah, right? And one has ibadah, and one has mu'amalat. Right? So there's three in the same hadith. اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتْ. Have taqwa to Allah wherever you are. This has to come from aqeedah. First, you know that there is ilah. Second, he is worthy of worship. Third, you have to have taqwa. It means you do what he does, what he wants, and avoid what displeases him. We explain taqwa, right? So that means when you have this taqwa, means you recognize Allah, you recognize worshipping him, not like the kuffar said he created, but he's there, he created, but no worship. But taqwa is worship. So you're gonna believe in that. تَقِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ كُنْ. That's the aqidah part. وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيَّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُوهَا. So we do bad deeds, that's the disobedience. And the ibadah is disobedience. Ibadah is to act, to do the right things. So when a person does wrong, this is disobedience. So how you're going to follow it with a good deed? Ibadah. Yani when you give somebody a sadaqah, that's a good deed. This is ibadah or not ibadah? It's ibadah, a form of ibadah. To wipe the bad deed, which was a shortcoming in ibadah. Instead of doing ibadah, you disobeyed Allah in his ibadah, in worshipping him. And then we fix it. I did another wrong thing. Then I come for salah, hasana. So this erases that. Like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the Sahabi come and tell him, I did a big mistake, big wrong, you know, thing. Yeah. So Asalam said, you prayed Fajr with us? He said, yes, Allah Azza wa Jal erases that. You are in the dhimma of Allah. Whoever prayed Fajr in the Jama'ah, fi dhimmatillahi hatta yumsi. He's in the protection of Allah until the night time comes. Subhanallah. Just praying Salat al-Fajr in Jama'ah. You know, one time, Al-Hajjaj ibn Yusuf, Arfil Al-Hajjaj? He was a big transgressor, you know, like killing people left and right for no reason. And one time, Salim, the son of Abdullah ibn Umar, with Abdullah ibn Umar, his father, يعني, was sitting in the majlis of Al-Hajjaj. This is a true story. Yeah? So they're both sitting there. And then Al-Hajjaj ibn Yusuf asked for someone bring him from the jail. From jail. And he told him, why you did this. He said, you will be killed right now. Right? And he told Salim, go kill him. Mushkila, right? It's a problem. So Abdullah ibn Umar sitting there, Sahabi of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Salim is a great faqih, muhaddith, great scholar of Medina. The son of Abdullah ibn Umar. MashaAllah, he was like Umar ibn al-Khattab. Tall, big, you know, strong, all of that. So he's sitting with Abdullah ibn Umar, and Al-Hajjaj now telling him to go kill someone. Zulm. He put him in this situation. He said, take him, kill him, whatever, the way you like. Go do it. So Salim takes him and go out. Right? So they go out, walk far as possible. Then Salim tell him, listen, did you pray Fajr in Jama'ah today? He tell him, yes. He said, Alhamdulillah, go your faith. He freed him, right? He goes back, because Al-Hajjaj told him to come back. After you kill him, come back, report, right? Now, if he did not kill him, he will kill him. Kill Salim, right? And that's what Abdullah ibn Umar's father was thinking. I know my son is not going to kill this guy. And he's going to come back and he will be killed right there in front of me. That's what his لا خلاص يعني I'm stuck here and I'm gonna see my son is getting murdered right now. So he comes and tell al-Hajjaj, tell him, did you kill him? He said, no. He said, then you'll be killed. Why did you not kill him? He said, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever prays Fajr in Jama'ah, he's in the protection of Allah. I cannot kill someone who's in the protection of Allah. So al-Hajjaj said, sadaqallah, sadaqallah. Allah Azza Jal is truthful, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is truthful. Khalas, go. So Abdullah ibn Umar told his son, سَمَّيْتُكَ سَالِمًا لِتَسْلَمْ. That's why I called you Salim. Right? Salim means safe, يعني, right? So I called you Salim, and Allah saved you, subhanAllah. So that's why, and I just mentioned that story to tell you the importance of Fajr Salah. Right? Salat al-Fajr. Remember that story and say it to your children, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Alright? So when you do a good deed, which is ibadah, it wipes the bad deed. Which is like a shortcoming in worshipping Allah, because we worship Allah wherever we are. At all times, we are created to worship Allah. How we worship Allah? By doing everything right, by doing everything in order. Correct? Mm-hmm. Now, what is a disobedience? When somebody commits a sin, what does that mean? You did not worship Allah. So how you erase that? By going back to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now you know why this second part of the hadith is covering the worship. First one is covering the aqidah in general. Yani. Second one is covering the worship in general as well. Third one is talking about our relationship with each other. Rasulullah ﷺ said, خالق الناس. الناس. يعني all people بخلقن حسن. He did not say, خالق the good people with good manners. No, he said, everybody. It's about you. What you can do is like have خلق حسن. Even people have خلق سيء. Some people have bad manners. You are allowed sometimes to reply in the same way. لا يحب الله الجهر بالسوء من القول إلا من ظلم. وإن عاقبتم فعاقبوا بمثل ما عوقبتم به. يعني if you reply within limits, يعني, then you are allowed. But if you hold it, it's better. So this is the exception. But in general, you have خلق حسن. You have خلق حسن. خلق حسن. So Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم here advised us with, give us three وصية. وصية means advice. يعني. Three. First one, اتقي الله حيث موجود. And this, by the way, hadith of Mu'adh رضي الله عنه. يعني if you, this hadith is narrated by Abu Dharr and Mu'adh. No. The famous narration we always quote is Mu'adh ibn Jabal. And the story is that Mu'adh ibn Jabal, being youth, being young, comes to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم, and he asks him to give him an advice. So Rasulullah ﷺ gave him the first one. Then he said, Zidni, give me more, Ya Rasulullah. Then he gave him the second advice. Then he said, Zidni, Ya Rasulullah, give him the third advice. And I like to mention that narration. Why? Because it shows how eager were the youth to go and learn. Not only having the customer, consumer mentality, right? We have to be provided. Like we are entitled that someone has to preach us. Someone has to teach us. Someone has to make a program for us. That's great. But you also have to be eager to go from the other side and demand. Like I was saying in the khutbah, come and claim, right? Come and try to say, we need such and such. That's good. That's why I feel very happy when I see youth coming to ask questions about the deen after Fajr or after Isha. You know, they like that. So this is a good thing. This is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. When the sahaba come, young one come and ask him for advice. And then he gives them golden, valuable advice. So it goes both ways, right? So he gave the first one, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْ. What is the taqwa? Avoiding the prohibitions and doing the right. That's taqwa, basically. اجْتِنَابُ مَا نَهَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ وَفِعْلُ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ. في كل وقت وفي كل حين وفي كل مكان. Every any place, any time, anyhow, you are going to avoid Allah's prohibition, ma'asiyah, and follow Allah's orders. هكذا التقوى. May Allah make us among المتقين. Among the متقين. And طبعا this goes in everything. So taqwa, it is like one of the, how we could say, evaluation tools. Okay? So when we say to do everything Allah ordered and avoid everything Allah prohibited, let's apply it to one thing. Quran, reciting the Quran. Okay, Allah ordered us to recite the Quran properly. So that's an order. So avoid reciting it not properly, improperly. Be respectful to the Quran and avoid being disrespectful. Allah told us when the Quran is recited, we listen attentively. So we avoid being engaged otherwise. You know, taqwa. So the taqwa is like your evaluation tool. Am I reading Quran with taqwa or not? Am I praying with taqwa or not? Am I giving sadaqah in taqwa with taqwa or not? You know, so taqwa is like taqillaha haythuma kunt. Okay? So taqwa is like one evaluation or one filter through which you know the quality of your ibadah and your act. So every time you say this act is act of muttaqin or not muttaqin, right? That's first question. How would I know? Before I do this, how Allah ordered me to do it? How Rasulullah showed me to do it? Am I doing it like that? Alhamdulillah. I'm not doing it like that? Stop and fix. Irhamkumullah. So this is how it is. Siyam, same thing. Zakah, same thing. Hajj, same thing. So taqwa is like your filter, is like your evaluation tool that you ask yourself how Allah ordered me and if I'm doing it or not, what Allah told me to avoid and am I doing it or not. Is that clear? Taqillaha haythumma kunt. So what's the second wasiyah? Second wasiyah here. Atbi'i as-sayyi'ata al-hasanata tamhuha. Subhanallah, Allah Azza wa Jalla knows that we are weak. خلق الإنسان ضعيفة. We are weak. And we are عجولة. You know, خلق الإنسان من عجل. You know, we are like rushing. And those two create lots of problems. Weak and rushing at the same time. You know, imagine someone weak and he jumps into the, you know, حلبة, يعني the arena, fighting arena, you know. You know, all these people with muscles and strong and experience and everything, and someone comes and says, yeah, who's going to fight me? You know, already jumping there. So he is weak, but he is hasty as well. So what is the result? Tell me what is the result. We'll be knocked down in a few seconds. Ala tour. So you are weak. Before you haste, you strengthen yourself. Where is Surah Al-Fatiha? Where is the Quran? Where is the dhikr? Where is the ibadah? Right? So this is how you exercise and protect yourself and the shield. If you are weak, you should have shields around you and don't haste. That means you're going to calculate. That's not the guy for me. Oh, that's not my fight. You know, wait for it. I defend myself before I attack anybody. Like that. So ضعيف وعجول. So be careful. Mu'min is not like that. We know we're weak. We strengthen ourselves with Allah Azza wa Jal. Dhikr of Allah, ibadah of Allah, it strengthens us. Makes you stronger and stronger and stronger. And put the shields around you, protection around you and all of that. So nobody can get to you. And then you are not hasty. You are not going to go into danger. لا تلقوا بأيديكم إلى التهلكة. Don't run into that. So we do, يعني Allah Azza wa Jal knows that we are weak. So that means sayyi'ah is going to happen. It's going to happen. That's why I said, atbi' sayyi'ah al-hasana. Follow bad deed with a good deed. It means bad deeds are going to happen. Yani if we don't make mistakes, Allah will create someone to make mistakes. So his name al-Tawwab, his name al-Rahim, his name al-Ghafoor will go in action. Otherwise, yani if we don't make mistakes. So you see? So Allah Azza wa Jalla al-Tawwab wal-Ghafoor wal-Rahim, you know, ghafir al-Dhanb wa qabil al-Tawb. So those have to be there. So Allah Azza wa Jalla have those attributes. So those attributes go in action when somebody make mistake. And we will make mistakes. So, but khayrul khatta'ina al-Tawwabun. Those who repent back to Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's why Allah says, Inna Allaha yuhibbu al-Tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-Mutatahhirin. Allah loves those who repent and Allah loves those who purify themselves. May Allah make us among at-tawwabin. May Allah make us among al-mutatahhirin. Naam. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. See, Allah called us mu'mineen. Allah told us, to be successful, you have to repent. Repent means you're going to do mistakes. So this is the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla, so you don't become you don't have despair. You don't despair from Allah's mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right. What are the best things to erase and wipe bad deeds? Fard. Fara'id. You know, fard, Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Hadith Qudsi, Rasulullah SAW narrated, مَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّ افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. Nothing will get my servant closer to me more than what I made obligatory for him. يعني, when you do the five daily salah, this is the best deed to get you closer to Allah. Allahu Akbar, gets you closer to Allah. What gets Allah love you to love you? Nafl. You see, you get closer and closer to Allah. Now you are closer. You want Allah to love you? You do the nafl. You do the sunan, yani. Two before, two after, this kind of. Those are what will make Allah love you. What gets you closer to Allah is what? Fard. What gets Allah to love you is what? Nafl. وما زال عبد يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه. Until I love him. So now understand? When somebody tells you, what is the importance of nafl? Why I have to do this? You tell them, one gets you closer, and one gets Allah to love you. Which one you choose? Which one you want to compromise now? You see, it's all in the style of teaching, ya akhwani. Someone says, you got to do the sunnah, beta. I have to do the sunnah, you know. But make them love it. Subhanallah, why it has to be, it's not fard. Why you are making it fard? You see what we do sometimes? Fard is fard. Okay, they understand, the kids understand. They will do the fard. But how you make them do the sunnah? Love the sunnah, because it's a sunnah, it's not a fard. Is it a fard? You have to pray two before and two after, four before and four after, otherwise it's not good. Now you're making it fard. It's not fard. Rasulullah himself said it's not fard. And if you don't do it, no, you are not going to be punished. But you need to do it. You see the difference? You need, you want to do it. You love to do it. It will help you to do it. It's one word difference only. Okay? So, the salawat al-khams, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, as-salawat al-khams, count with me, as-salawat al-khams, the five. Wal-jum'atu ila al-jum'a. Wal-jum'atu, say it, wal-jum'atu, wa ramadanu ila ramadan. How many now? Three. الصلوات الخمس والجمعة إلى الجمعة ورمضان إلى رمضان مكفرات ما بينهن. سيد مكفرات ما بينهن إذا اجتنب الكبائر. إذا اجتنب الكبائر. As long as you're avoiding major sins, as long as the person avoiding major sins, those three will automatically, see autopilot, يعني, automatically wiping whatever in between. Allahu Akbar. So Fajr till Dhuhr. If no major sin committed in the middle, all your minor sins wiped. From Zuhr to Asr, you pray Zuhr, then you pray Asr, anything in the middle, wiped. And Asr to Maghrib, Maghrib to Isha, Isha to Fajr, like that, automatically. From Ramadan to Ramadan, anything in the middle, wiped, no major sin, alhamdulillah. Anything under major sin, gone. Allahu Akbar. See? And then, Jum'ah to Jum'ah, same thing. So one daily, one weekly, one annually. Barakah, subhanAllah. As long as we avoid. وفي حديث آخر, there is another hadith, Al-Umratu ila al-Umrati kaffaratun lima baynahuma. So from Umrah to Umrah. So if you do Umrah every 2 years, every 3 years, same thing. So you have daily, weekly, annually, and endlessly. Allahu Akbar. So Al-Hasanat, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Inna Al-Hasanati yudhibna Al-Sayyat. Hasanat truly make the Sayyat gone. The third wasiya, which we'll finish with inshallah, Khaliqin Nasa bi-Khuluqin Hasan. The first two is how you deal with your Creator. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third one is how to deal with the creation, the people, subhanallah. How you become smiling at people, how you become welcoming, you know, this welcoming attitude and demeanor, how you talk with people nicely, how to act, how to initiate, how to react to those who speak good or those who speak bad, This is the khuluq al-hasan. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam said in the hadith, narrated in Tirmidhi also, أَكْمَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا أَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا. You know, the person who, the perfect believer among the believers, yani, the perfect one, is the one that who have perfect manners. So the more good manners you have, the more of faith you have. So your iman becomes better as long as your behavior is better. So the better your behavior, the better your iman. The perfect your behavior, the perfect your iman. The less your behavior, the less your iman as well. And this is what Rasulullah said, so it's not me. So if you find someone is keep dealing with people in a negative manner, their iman is, you are not going to judge them or go tell them that. But this is the standard. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us what? Standard. Said, the better behavior, the better faith you have. Lesser behavior, negative behavior, lesser faith you have. So your choice. Okay, your choice. And how you fix that? You go back to number two. You go back to number two. That you follow bad deed with a good deed. So if you deal with someone harshly, don't do a good deed. Go do a good deed. Ask them forgiveness. Right? So this is how it will work. Also, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the closest to me in Yawm al-Qiyamah are the best of manners. أقرب الناس مني مجلسا يوم القيامة أحسنهم أخلاقا. Yani the people who are closest to me in Yawm al-Qiyamah are the people who are best of manners. So best of manners is best of faith, and best of manners closer to? So you have to decide what is your distance from Rasulullah. How many blocks you live يعني, in Jannah. How many subdivisions you are away from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Never. Everybody wants their house to be in a golf course or in the river bank or in the mountain or whatever it is. So they choose the location, correct? And the better the location, the more demanded, the more money that you do. Why? Because you want that location. So what location you want in Jannah? Closest to Rasul al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And how you gain that location? By putting the deposit in this dunya. What is the deposit? Khuluq al-Hasan. Al-Khuluq al-Hasan. So today we learned, alhamdulillah, that Al-Khuluq al-Hasan gets you better iman, better faith, better relationship with Allah. Al-Khuluq al-Hasan gets you better with people. Al-Khuluq al-Hasan gets you closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We also learned that we are weak, and we are continuing, we continue to make bad deeds. But as long as we avoid major sins, we make conscious effort to avoid major sins, Allah gives us gifts to wipe those bad deeds. We make conscious effort to wipe the bad deeds by doing good deeds, but when we continue doing salah, fasting Ramadan, doing umrah, hajj, jum'ah, all of this wipes whatever in between. We also learned that we have to have taqwa, which is like a filter, which is like the evaluation form with us to see the quality of our deeds. So we'll stop here, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, and the next time we'll continue with another beautiful hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam about al-muraqabah and watchfulness for Allah. Jazakumullah khairan, wa alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.